I am Milka Jagale, working as Assistant Professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, we are going to learn operators in the Scilab. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, student will be able to perform mathematical, relational, and logical operations on vectors using Scilab. So Scilab consists of these operators, especially mathematical operators, relational or conditional operators, logical operators. Mathematical operators. The various mathematical operations possible on vectors are addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, element-wise multiplication, element-wise division, and transpose. So before going to the operations on vectors, let's see how the vectors are represented in Scilab. Vectors are represented by square brackets, a sequence of number separated by commas or space are represented as a vectors. So let's see the first operation, that is addition. Let's define two vectors, vector A and vector B. The elements in the vector A are 10, 20, 30, and elements in the vector B are 5, 10, and 15. So for the addition, we use plus operator in the Scilab. When vector A is added to the vector B, then we get answer as 15, 30, 45. Which is the addition of elements of corresponding element in the vector A and element in the vector B. That is 10 plus 5 is 15. The next operation, that is subtraction. The subtraction of two vectors can be done by using minus operator. So let me tell you, addition, subtraction can be done. Define A vector as 20, 40, 60 and B vector as 10, 20, 30. So when a condition is given as vector A minus vector B, the answer comes as 10, 20, 30, which is subtraction of a corresponding element of vector A, that is 20 minus 10, that is 10. So let's move towards the third operation, that is multiplication. So here, a condition is that a row vector should be multiplied with a column vector. Two rows cannot be multiplied. Either one of the rows should be column or row. So vector A is defined as 10, 20, 30 and vector B is defined as 5, 10 and 15. When the both are multiplied, that is A multiplied by B, it gives us 700, that is vector A multiplied by vector B, it gives answer as 700. That is 10 into 5 plus 20 into 10 plus 30 into 15. That comes to 700. So let's see division. Vector A is defined as 10, 20, 30, whereas vector B is 5, 10, 15. When 10 is divided by 5, we get 2. 20 is divided by 10, we get 2, and 30 divided by 15, we get 2. So the answer is 2. The operator used for division is slash. So element wise multiplication. Here, corresponding element of both the vectors are multiplied and the answer is given. That is vector A 10 is multiplied by the 10 of vector A is multiplied by 5 of vector B, that is 10 into 5 comes as 50. And finally, the operator in the vector into column vector or column vector into row vector. So vector A is defined as 10, 20 and 30, and if we give operator A dash, then the answer comes as the row vector A is converted into column vector 10, 20 and 30. So relational and conditional operator. the various relational operations which are done on the vectors are, there are mainly six operators which are used in Scilab. If the answer is, they have, in this they do the mathematical operations. If the answer is true, it gives as T, and if the answer is false, it gives the answer as F. So there are operators less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal to. Relational or conditional operator. So let's see the first operator, that is less than. So let's define two vectors x and vector x and vector y. Vector x is defined as 2, 3, 7, 8, and vector y is defined as 2, 4, 5, 1. So the condition given here is z equal to x less than y. So in this, it compares according to the condition whether the element x is less than y, and then if it is true, it gives us T, and if it is false, it gives us false. So here 2 is less than 2, so if it comes as 8 is less than 1, it is false, so it comes as false. 7 is less than 5, it is false. 3 is less than 4, it is true. And 2 is less than 2, it is false. So next operator, that is less than or equal to. So two vectors as similar, 2, 3, 7, 8, vector x, and vector y, 2, 4, 5, 1. So here you see, the condition is that x is less than or equal to. It compares the corresponding element in the position of the vector. It see that 2 is less than or equal to 2. Yes, it is true. 2 is equal to 2, so its answer is true. And 3 is less than or equal to 4. So yes, 3 is less than 4, so it shows answer as true. So 7 is less than 5, answer is false. So the answer is F. Next, greater than symbol. Here you see two vectors x and y. The condition given here is x is greater than y. So see the condition, 2 is greater than 2, no, it is false. So F is given as answer. It is 3 is greater than 5, yes. 7 is greater than 5, so true is given as answer. In the same way, greater than or equal to operation is done. Here equal to sign, two vectors are defined, and if both the vectors are equal, then only the 2, 4, false. The answer is F. In the same way, complement of is also given, not equal to operator. 2 is equal to 2, it is true, but the answer is false, because answer will be the complement of equal to. So logical operator, AND operator, OR operator, and NOT operator. So in the AND operator, a condition is given. Answer is true only if both the conditions OR operator. Here the answer is false. The OR operator, here the answer is true. Either one of the statement satisfies. NOT operator. These are the references. Book by Stephen Campbell and a book by Ramachandran and Nair. Thank you.